It's like everything everywhere is going crazy, so we don't go out anymore. We sit in the house, and slowly the world we're living in is getting smaller, and all we say is, please, just leave us alone. Well, I'm not going to leave you alone. I want you to get mad. I want all of you to get up out of your chairs and go to the window, open it, and stick your head out and yell.
The Dean Blundell Show.
This is mass madness, you maniacs.
102.1 The Edge.
This is your Edge Files with Dean Blundell on the Edge.
Lots going on. Girl had to be rescued. This is high. Like, you know you're stoned when. She climbed a 40-foot electricity pylon thinking it was a bridge after smoking weed.
Just weed?
That's good weed.
Unreal.
Wow.
Horrified locals spotted the 21-year-old from the Czech Republic trying to cross a river on a power line.
Ooh.
She's like, holding on to the other power line. Hang on. Because you know when you cross the two power lines, what happens is she'd explode. An onlooker said it was a nightmare. No, because she was very much under the influence of drugs, was giggling and laughing, saying, I'm going across the bridge. As she climbed the power line. She got down, though. People rescued her. Apparently, she was fine, laughing the whole time. And then she asked where she was, and they said, hey, you climbed a power line. She started to laugh again, and that's when they took her in for a psychological evaluation. Now, that is good weed.
I want some of that.
If you are so stoned that you mistake power lines for a bridge.
Yeah.
And she was so motivated, too.
And then when you get down, you don't know what you've done. And then they tell you, and you go, yippee. That's stoned.
That's like bath salt category.
Yeah,
that's
probably. Jesus. Freak me out. In case you're wondering if you wanted to become a clown, I want you to listen to a story of Sundance the Clown, otherwise known as Thomas Morgan. A 47-year-old got himself arrested after police searched his home and found child porn on his computer. Police obtained the search warrant after noticing someone using his internet service provider account to download copious amounts of stuff in a file-sharing program. They keep tabs on that now? On the stuff that you download?
That's good.
Well, that's good in this case, but I'm just wondering generally.
I don't know.
Yeah.
I guess they do.
Because, boy, you can find all my dog porn. Anyway, police said the amount of child porn they found on Sundance, the clown's computer, wasn't that substantial, but enough material that they were concerned. Apparently, his 20 years of perfecting his craft, working with children, on his website, it says, my educational background is childhood development, so I know how to interact with kids.
Oh, that's horrible.
Clowns just freak me out in general.
Dude, I know. Never become a clown.
Like, I can understand if, you know, you're a family member and someone said, I bought this clown outfit at a store. Do you mind just being the clown for the party today? But to actually go and look
even
for a clown.
Even then, I'd say no.
Yeah, I know, yeah. I know. But
no, because if I put that on, I might grab a kid. And that is not desirable. No, I do not want to. If I put that on, that six-year-old might start looking all right.
If you're a professional clown.
With the suit comes like these crazy superpowers.
You can do balloon animals in regular street clothes.
Yeah.
Kids will still like them.
It's like a priest. So the clown outfit minus the makeup.
It's just a very dark clown.
Yeah. And can I have a drum roll, please? So, ladies and gentlemen, Rob Ford. Gave out his first key to the city yesterday. This is the mayor of the city.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. To the founder of McDonald's Canada.
No way.
Yeah, man.
Go figure that one out.
George Cohan, who I know, he's a great guy. Yeah. Just a super, super guy. Anyway, he brought McDonald's to, thankfully, to Canada in the 70s. And the rest is history. Handed him the key yesterday. We're going to reenact how that went. Derek is going to be...
I'll be George.
Derek's going to be George, a venerable man, businessman. Mm-hmm. Could be one of the nicest, most fun guys you've ever met.
Yep.
And I'll be Tub of Guts. Music done. Oh, my God.
Hi, Mr. Ford.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Is he talking to me? Oh, my God. It's you.
What's this all about?
Oh, my God. He's talking to me. Thank you for coming today, Jesus.
No, it's George.
Yeah.
Pronounced differently.
I call you Jesus, man. You changed my life.
Why am I here today, sir?
I'm going to give you the key to my heart. I mean, the city.
could you just back one step away?
No, man. I just want to smell you. You smell like sesame seeds, no,
don't,
Jesus.
Don't smell me, please.
How did you come up with that special sauce? Oh, my God.
We had a team of people come up with that. It wasn't me.
It was you. You are the brightest man in the whole world.
Oh, thank you, but that's too kind. Anyway.
Oh, God. Can I touch you?
Just get your hands off me.
Can I touch your beef patties?
No.
Please,
no.
Beef patties.
Security.
Can I lick you?
No. Back off.
If I lick you, would you taste like Thousand Island dressing?
The stage is starting to shake.
Oh, my God, because I'm going to whack it. wait a second. I got to turn around. You're the best person in the world.
McWhack it.
My God, I McWorship you. You are a damn visionary. You make Stephen Hawking look retarded. Or maybe it's the wheelchair.
Oh, those are your Edgefiles. Yeah. Whatever the hell day it is in, thank you, June 2012.
The Edgefiles
on 102.1.
The Edge.
The Dean Blundell Show.
I have some bad things to say about those people.
The Dean Blundell Show.
Friggin', I heard it. Flying through my friggin' damn wall.
The Dean Blundell Show.
Boom, man.
102.1.
Friggin', I knew it.
The Edge.
Here's one from a guy. Hey, my buddy is a 30-year-old virgin. I won't tell you his name because I actually don't want to embarrass him. We want to get him a lady. Brackets. Escort. Mm-hmm. I got it. What do you think? Is that something we should do for him, or is it something that's too gross? Thanks, Chris. I personally don't think it's good, but if he's in and he hasn't had sex, who am I to judge? And as our friend Voodoo the porn star, and I can't believe I'm taking advice from Voodoo the porn star, said yesterday, I don't judge because I don't want to be judged. So if you take the same approach, anything goes, and if your buddy's into it, take him.
That's like winning the Stanley Cup in your first year of hockey, though. Like,
well, it depends on what kind of escort they get him.
Yeah, okay, fair enough.
It was that one girl, what was her name? Cupid?
Oh, jeez.
Cupid the hooker, who wanted to have sex with us for a Monopoly game.
Yeah.
Asked if we give her a Monopoly game because she had to give a gift to her kid. Remember that?
Yeah, I do. Anytime an escort is also selling Penthouse magazines from 1992 on the side as a side business, you know she's not doing that well.
That's right. But I would do it for him, for sure.
Yeah, I'd do it. Do it. Yeah. Do it.
Get him a lady.
Yeah, do it.
Do it.
Do it.
Do
it.
Get him a girl. Do it.
Do it.
Do it now. Do it. Seriously, do it. Hey, The Edge.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm fantastic. How are you?
I'm doing well.
Excellent.
What's your name?
Candace.
Hi, Candace. What's your question?
My question was, what is a girl supposed to do when a guy, as a friend, totally platonic, just friends, but the guy has obvious some sort of feelings for the girl, but it's just not going to work?
Okay, we have to get a little more first person here. So someone likes you, you don't like them, and you don't know how to break it to him that you don't because you think he's a nice person.
Yeah, exactly.
He's great. Like, he's probably one of the nicest people I've ever met in my entire life, would never work. I have a boyfriend.
Plus, you have a boyfriend?
And he knows about it. It's very well aware, and my boyfriend's probably listening right now. So, hi, babe. I love you.
Well, he's probably going to kick that guy's ass is what he's going to do.
Honestly, if you have a boyfriend, what does the guy say? Is he being forward? Did he tell you that he wants to hook up with you? What did he say?
No, not at all. It's just friends at work obviously know, but I don't see it, and I don't like him, but...
Well, if he hasn't been forward with you and said anything to you, don't go and embarrass him and say, no, I don't like you, because what happens if he's just being overly nice? Or he could be gay.
He could be. He hasn't gotten laid in a really long time.
See? This is the thing. Maybe he's one of those guys. He's a girl guy. There's guy guys and girl guys.
He's a girl guy. He cooks very well, extremely well.
Dude, how do I know this? I am like Dr. Phil on crack.
Listen, you can't say the guy's gay, though. I think he's just got a big crush on this girl, and that's the problem.
How do you know? Dude, he doesn't have sex. He cooks really well. Is he very... Does he dress really neatly?
Not entirely.
Is he in really good shape?
No, absolutely not.
Oh, well, then he's not gay.
I think the problem is he wants you. And he I'm actually being serious.
Just to, you know what? Yeah. If he ever gets to the point where he says
tell
something...
Him. Yeah, just tell him.
Don't tell him if he hasn't done anything outward, right? Like, if he sees her and likes her and hasn't said he likes her, doesn't come on to her, doesn't none of that stuff, you don't want to embarrass the poor bastard.
How about this? Try and set him up with women.
And it hasn't worked, and the other women are just like, no, it's just not going to work.
He sounds ugly.
Just walk up to him and start a conversation and say, man, I took the most killer dump yesterday.
That's a definite conversation that's happened.
See? Oh, you have? Well, just gross him out.
Or you know what you do? If he wants to get to you and he can and he might be gay, share dildos. It's the closest he'll get to you.
Or just wait until he tries something and tell him you have a boyfriend.
Well, he knows I have a boyfriend. It's obvious. Everybody knows I have a boyfriend.
Oh, well.
I think you should share dildos.
I don't think you should share dildos. Actually, maybe.
It's like the best of both worlds for this guy.
That's true. Yeah. Hi, The Edge.
Hey, boys.
Cyrus.
Well, I was wondering if I could tell you guys about the easiest job I've ever had. Can I get a drum roll?
No.
Oh, wow. The audacity.
No, you can't have a drum roll.
All right, well...
Drum rolls are reserved for things that we know are funny.
Well, you always give me a drum roll, and you know I'm
all
never
right,
funny, right?
All right. Jesus, Cyrus, here's your drum roll. Go ahead.
So, I used to work at a pet store, and it was so easy, because half the time I just effed the dog, and the other half I stood around avoiding work.
It's a bestiality joke, Cyrus.
Yeah.
Yeah, we don't do bestiality jokes here.
Yeah, never.
No. Thanks. Hi, The Edge.
Hi.
You try so hard.
You take it out?
Yeah, I do. I don't know. I don't even know what's right or wrong anymore, so I'm just taking stuff out as I can.
No, but that's the expression of, like...
F the dog?
Yeah.
Yeah, I get it. Hi, The Edge. No, but he really...
Man. Hi.
Hi, who's this?
Brian.
Oh, yeah.
Actually, that was his best joke.
Yeah, it was actually pretty good.
What's happening, pussycat?
I am wondering why most... I would say 70% of guys, maybe not... are very antisocial. Not all, right? Some are very social, but...
Is your boyfriend antisocial?
Yes.
Well, in what way? Like, he didn't like going out, doesn't like looking at people, talking to people?
Yes.
How old is he?
28.
He's getting there.
Guys are just kind of do their own thing, though. Like, they're
when comfortable they get older,
with it.
Yeah. Guys, when they get older, between 26 and 35, I would say, you go from being very, very social to not wanting to see anybody.
That's right.
That's why they create lazy boys for us and stuff. Like, that's all we want.
They're called lazy boys.
Yes, that's all we need.
Absolutely.
We're very happy. Give us a home theater, and we're like, that's the older we get, that's all you need.
I call the 30s the hermit decade.
What happens if, like, because I'm not.
Does it bug you?
Yeah.
Okay. How long have you been dating this guy?
2 years.
How's the sex?
Great.
Yeah, that's all you need.
You deal with it, then.
Yeah. Yes.
Okay, I have to put up with it. Okay.
I have to put up with it, then. Well, you know what? Be social with him in places that he's comfortable being social, right? Like, you know, does he have friends?
Couple.
Is he kind of a loser?
No, we used to have lots of friends.
Is he kind of a guy's guy, though? Okay.
Yeah, I would say.
He's a guy's guy?
Yeah.
But does he just not like hanging out with other people?
Yeah, I think that's it. Yeah.
Oh, that'll never change.
He's just like an introvert, and you're like the extrovert.
Yeah, just become. My dad's the same way. And I am now becoming that way too.
Couples like that actually last longer, to be honest.
Oh, my dad worships my mom because she's the only friend he's got. Because he doesn't like anybody else.
Yeah.
Yeah. And they're great because my mom's very social.
Yeah, your dad
and my
just
dad's very quiet and very easygoing, but they're perfect for each other that way. So who knows? Maybe
those couples work out better.
Well, yeah. I guess that makes sense. You know, I can do the social things. Yeah.
So get off his back.
Yeah. Hey, easy. Okay.
Yeah, the worst you can do to someone like that is to pressure them into stuff that, like, social situations.
Yeah, and not give up the sex. Hi, The Edge. Hello.
How do you get that smell out of your fingers?
Oh, that's the worst Beavis ever.
It's like a Scottish Beavis.
Not bad.
That's because I got a sore throat. Anyway.
What?
Anyway.
It's a good question.
Cool.
How do you get to that smell out of your fingers?
Oh, it's a legit question. Yeah. Okay.
Two ways, actually. Fast Orange is really good. If you're a cereal hand blaster, get a big tub of that.
Wow.
Yeah.
Fast Orange. Gets the grease out, too.
Okay. Just in case you're with a bigger girl.
Yeah. Get that fried chicken grease out, too. Yeah.
Or kerosene if it's real bad. And just burn it off.
Oh, yeah. Burn it, light your hand on fire.
Grease fire.
Dude, I remember I was like 17. Yeah. True story.
I had to put gas.
I had to go in the garage and put gas on him because it was so bad.
Fingers.
Yeah.
The Dean Blundell Show. Mornings on The Edge.
And now, The Dean Blundell Show presents The Week in Review. Yeah. It's true. Week in Review.
So, I had parent-teacher interviews this week. I don't know.
Those are a blast.
So much fun.
Parents look forward to that stuff.
So much fun. And in this parent-teacher interview, one of the teachers encouraged me told me how to be a parent. Yeah.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, yeah.
Did you snap?
No.
No.
No, you know what? I didn't, and I learned something about myself sitting there listening to this person. Yeah, you should do this. You should do that. You should do this. You should do that. You should do this. And I thought to myself, you Russian? How can you be a French teacher if you're Russian? She's a French teacher. But you're Russian.
What kind of teacher should she be?
Russian. Russian teacher.
You're all going to have weird...
So I didn't take anything she said seriously. I'm like, I think you're faking it. I think you're faking one of the two, the French or the Russian. This is off. Anyway, leads us to your week in review.
I would have been eating a different kind of sandwich. Yeah, yeah, like, yeah. I would have just gone and made a sandwich.
Oh, I had to just fake chow it right there.
Yeah.
Did you fake chow it or did you get right in?
Oh, I got right in there.
Right after you were there?
I was a fat guy all my life. When you're eating something, you're eating something.
Test 1, 2.
Oh, that feels good.
Making everyone eat it all the time. Pounding a stuffed bear.
Kind of look like the Sperminator.
I built a slut bear.
It's a slippery slope.
Wide end first.
Yeah. Hormonal.
Someone sharts, everybody gets E. coli.
Our clock's just a little longer.
Put the finger in the tuchus.
Whoa.
What about the swass?
The swussy.
The SWAT team.
Fleshy, meaty mushroom, a masturbation toy.
Only a freaking pinky.
Kim Kardashian.
The only girl with a fatter ass than me!
Some sort of a cannonball.
Depending on how old, there's probably a lot of hair in it.
Yeah, and suction.
Mouth on the other side of this hole.
It's not like I said I wanted to put my thing in her thing.
Talk to a girl in a garbage bag, but not me.
Bingo. Fake chow.
Beloved Mr. Turtle Pools.
He's like G.I. gay.
Oh, he's in your face, kid.
Taste some other...
Fantastic. Lots of meal!
Hey, can you spare some poontang?
Big deal. So he's walking across the falls.
Should do it from one side of Rob Ford to the other.
Swalls, swussy, swat.
Swak?
Swagina.
And I don't want any guys' balls on my leg!
I hate my shemales with pubic hair, though.
Try it, unless it's in the form of a colostomy bag, then don't.
What for bum sweat?
Or just take the bag off and do that.
Gagendeep.
You've got ass.
He tried to use 3 dildos.
And she spits.
And he knocked up her mouth.
Deep within yourself.
Want to smell my fart?
Behind your back there.
Beaver!
5 inches.
Long?
Wide?
No, wide.
When you put that there?
Thrusts of fun.
Go ugly and double bag it.
Cop came and shot it.
Go fat and double bag it.
That was a beer bottle.
Oh, c- on your back.
And there's a big breath coming off of it.
I can get a fight with you like the Black Eyed Peas.
The real you was really putting in your mouth. Smoked her head on the garage door.
Butt slut.
Stuck his feet in the back of his gitch.
Put peanut butter there.
Yeah, that's when she sat on his face.
That guy in a tank top.
Minus the hookers and blow.
Especially when there's gooey stuff.
It's a tough one because Chris Brown's only used to hitting women. And I think Drake makes a fist with his two or three fingers put together at the end of his hand. So, you know, I think he thinks that he's a
fit. I was at the mall the other day and I bought myself some new sneakers.
My name's Aubrey.
It's just Drake and some wife beater.
Unfortunately, Drake's posse has a U in it.
Herb is first.
A big drizzly.
Herb is first.
You can't see my feet. I'm standing on a toilet seat.
Herb is first.
I'm not a tough guy.
Tough guy.
I got herpes first.
I was beeping his girlfriend.
And then I went to Mr. Greek. Mr. Greek.
With my friend who is a geek. Is a geek.
I gotta take a leak. Take a leak.
313.
Ow. Oh, God, you all right, though? Ow. The Dean Blundell Show on the Edge.
Hello.
Hey.
Hello.
How's it going?
Good, man. How are you?
Good.
What's your name?
Alex.
What's your question?
So, I don't know. For some reason, I just can't stop thinking about try and hook up with an older girl, like someone who's like 30, 35, something like that. Mm-hmm.
How old are you?
19.
It's so, like shooting fish in barrel, buddy.
It might be my neighbor, because my neighbor's like smoking hot.
She's, oh, really?
Like 33 or something. But no, but I was thinking about it before, so I have
well,
no idea.
Well, I... First of all, as a someone that will probably only exclusively be with someone who's older than him, I know me. Yeah. I'm saying I am, and yeah. I've always liked that idea. I've always liked the idea, and it comes from the time when I was much younger, and I was with a woman who's probably 7 or 8 years older than me.
Yeah,
and she taught me stuff, and I appreciated it. And she was a woman. You know what I mean? Like there's girls your age are girls. A lot of 19-year-old girls are girls. 30-year-old girls are women normally, traditionally. Yeah. So it's, you appreciate a woman, you don't want a girl.
Well, it's funny because the fact that I actually talked to my boss about it, and he's like, you know, almost 50 or whatever like that. And he goes, man, he's like, yeah, we'll trade. He's like, bring over one of your hot young girlfriends and all that.
It is a little weird, huh? How it is a little weird how guys, yeah, like younger guys want to be with an older chick and older guys want to be with a younger chick. And it never kind of works out. It only works out for the younger guy and the older woman.
Yeah, I guess that's true. Yeah, that's all you ever see.
Yeah.
Like, you never really find a guy that's, like, you know, 20 with a girl that's 35, 40, right?
Unless you're Mariah Carey.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's
true. What's the oldest woman you've been with?
26.
How? And you're 19?
Yeah.
She like it?
I'm assuming so.
I'm assuming.
It happened more than once.
Oh, did it? Get into your 30s. There's a couple cards you need to get before you're 20. You got to get your 20s before you're 20. You got to get your 30s before you're 30, before you're 20 as well. So get your 20s card, your 30s card. And if you can go to Crocodile Rock, and you know what you should do is pour some really cheap cologne on yourself.
Dracar Noir or whatever.
Yeah. Put some high karate underneath your cheekbones. And go over to Crocodile Rock and, you know, wear something that makes you look like... I don't know, Italian.
Are you in shape, dude?
Yeah, and I've been growing a beard since I was like 13, so that's no problem. Getting ID and stuff like that's no problem. Everyone thinks I'm. That's probably why. Like I look like I'm 24, 25, anyways. Until
you start. I wonder where you'd go other than Crocodile Rock to pick up like a, you know, a 35, 40 year old.
I don't know anymore.
Corral. What's
ever
that?
Heard of the Corral?
The Corral? No.
In Oshawa?
Oh, dude. No.
Come on.
You don't want to get an STD, buddy.
How about just Oshawa?
I thought he said older chicks, not gross older chicks.
No, but a couple of my buddies go there, and it's just like a total cougar bar everywhere. Man.
Really?
Like, chicks are just put together there. You're like, oh, those are fake, that's fake.
There's nothing wrong with fake.
Mm. And the 19's coming out right now. Eh?
Yeah,
totally. His big boobsy.
Yeah, that's why it probably won't work out for him. These women got boobies. Hi, The Edge.
Hi. Hey.
So my question is finding out that a girl had an abortion a good enough reason to stop seeing her?
Nope.
No.
I mean, not.
Are you? What are you? Pro-life?
Not in like a moral sense. In like a
creeped out sense.
Just creeped out. Like she's.
Dude, you ever have a surgery of any kind?
No.
Never.
No.
Never had a procedure. Never had a root canal. Never had any of that stuff.
Teeth pulling. Not really.
Okay. I see. You had your teeth pulled. First of all, you don't know the reasons why she had it and what it meant to her then, and I'll be very serious with you now. Okay? I want you to listen very carefully to Dean. If you've never listened to anybody, listen. Do you like this girl?
Yeah.
Yeah. Do you really like her?
Yeah.
That's why it creeped you out? How long are you dating?
About 3 months, but it wasn't the fact that she got it. It's just the fact that, I found out from another person. She kind of, hit it and
of course. Dude, she's embarrassed because she knew that this would happen. I used to say that to my ex-wife all the time. Why are you telling me this until now? I'm like, because I knew this would happen anyway. What's the point?
Dude, absolutely not. I mean, if she got it during the time she was dating you, that might be different. Because of someone else.
Yeah.
I'm going to make this work.
And you know what? If you like her, she treats you well. Everybody has had bad things happen to them, whether they've had an abortion or whether they stole something. Or everybody. And the abortion one, to me, is such a no comment,
who
no
cares?
Starter.
It's a personal thing for her. And if anything, support her. Maybe ask her why.
Tell her you're sorry that it had to happen, and if you ever need to talk about it, and tell her you like her or love her if you love her, and just be there for her. Don't be a dick.
Yeah. Well, I've never
had an abortion.
Mentioned it to her. Well, no, obviously I've never had an abortion.
You've probably had a lobotomy though.
No, you're good. Well, it doesn't mention it to her. She doesn't know you know.
Well, I think she knows that I know.
Well, talk to her about it then.
I was thinking about that, but what if she gets creeped out that I know.
Well, no. It depends how you present it to her, though, right?
You know what the problem is today? I'll tell you what the problem is. And you seem like a real nice guy, and I know it's a genuine concern. The problem is there's no men left.
People just don't know how to be direct, talk about it, support her.
There's no men left. Men, if they have a problem, talk to someone about it. They don't yell and scream and freak out. Men, if they find out their girl had an abortion, they go, hey, babe, don't worry about it. I'm cool. I love you. I'm sorry that happened. Hopefully it wasn't in a back alley from a woman named Marta that had a coat hanger and some ether. Are you okay?
Are you exactly? What was the situation? I don't know any woman who hasn't had one.
I've had several.
They're all the rage.
I love them. Yeah. I just want to date chicks that have had them.
I go after all of them. Yeah.
You know, and had that ever happened to me, had I ever found out about that with anybody ever, I'd have the same response because it's not up to you to judge what she's gone through, right? I know a woman that was taken advantage of in a foreign country and had a kid because of it. And she had the kid. And everybody's like, you got to get rid of it. You got to get rid of it. And she's like, no, this is what it's
personal preference. And
so
it's,
you support her there, too.
Exactly.
It's like, would you date somebody who has been in jail?
I don't know.
No.
That's a great question, actually. That is a great question.
Or a girl with red hair.
Who's been in jail?
Yeah. By the edge.
Hey, how you doing, Dean?
Good, bud.
Listen now. My wife loves animals. We got these two dogs. The one dog's chomping our couches, our everything apart. And she's really upset that I want to get rid of this thing, eh? What do I do with her? You know what I mean?
Sounds like you have a big backyard.
I got a big backyard, bro.
Here's what you do. You go to the pet store, you get the spray that you spray on crap. The dogs won't eat it anymore.
Tastes like horrible.
Eat awful.
We've done that, brother. It f***ing eats everything. Ate a bottle of meat the other day.
I'm sorry. We're not doing dog questions today. Should I keep the dog? Should I give it away?
I was just thinking of other places to spray that stuff so I wouldn't have to eat it.
Yeah.
Keep the dog away from the cat.
I could have used that for the last 13 years. Hey, do you want to? Shh, shh. Oh.
I can't can't do that. Yeah, it's right here on the label. Yeah.
Okay. Actually, I didn't need a spray thing for that.
Oh, you can.
That was verbal.
That's what you used to spray at.
Yeah.
Wait a second.
Yeah.
It's the exact same.
Yeah.
I can't tell the difference. Some of
the Dean Blundell Show.
Wake up.
Mornings.
Wake up.
On the Edge.
Eddie Edge.
Hey.
Hey.
Nate from Oakville. How are you today?
Good. What's up?
Well, I just wanted to say that there is good men left over.
We were talking about that before. It was a good conversation because guys call in and they go, I don't know, what should I do? Should I talk to my girl about this? She had an abortion. Should I be a man? And you know what? I'm of the opinion, and because I hear guys being a separated, nearly divorced dude that has his kids half the time and fought very, very hard to have that. And you know, has considerably, and Todd knows this, I have a considerable amount less. the home I live in is much smaller, and I'm cool with it because
I have more than you now.
Yeah, you do. Totally, and I don't care.
I know.
But you know, it really is, and I mean this. You know, you hear about guys who go, yeah, I see my kids three times a month. I'm cool. You know, it gives me time to go out. I know guys that, and this pissed me off. I know guys that have just left their families and send Christmas gifts for their children in cabs. So
that's
they don't have to show up.
No way.
Oh, just the world. Men are gone. Men that step up to the plate. That's what we need, and we don't have it. And if I can encourage anybody out there, sorry, dude, one second. If I can encourage anybody out there that feels like they're not doing their job as a man, you probably aren't. So go and do it. Go ahead.
It's the hard thing.
Yeah.
As soon as it's hard. When it's hard and you do it, now you're a man.
Are we talking about the same thing?
Are you talking about men or she men?
Real men. Like, yeah. I just had my second kid 2-3 weeks ago.
Yeah. Congrats, buddy. Congrats.
Thank you. And it's the best thing ever. And if any way possible, if someone's going to try and stop that, I'm going to fight and fight and fight and fight and fight.
Yeah.
You know, just like you were saying, because my brother's in the same situation, and he's like you. You just keep going.
You don't stop.
You got to keep going.
Stop. You don't stop it. For those folders, it's embarrassing, and they embarrass the whole men.
Gender.
They embarrass them badly.
And you know what? I can say through this whole process, and it's been one of the worst years I can remember. It's just been full of grief, and that's the only word I can use to describe it. Just grief, personal grief in many days. And so, you know, there's been lots of days where I've been going down for my nap, and I thought, if I don't wake up tomorrow, I'll be fine with that. You know, in dark moments like that. And everybody does. And I'd be lying if I said I didn't have them because it's not easy. It's hard.
Yeah.
You know, but the hardest things to do are always where you learn the most about yourself.
Well, Dean, I'm going to give you a compliment real quick.
Yeah.
Last week there was a golf tournament that you said all these famous guys were going, and then there's Dean Blundell.
Yeah, the Joe Carter Classic.
And you're selling yourself short a little bit. Just for the idea that when I listen all the time and there's these guys that call in, you know what? You're giving good advice. You're helping out a lot of people, whether you think it or not. Don't sell yourself short. These guys were professional athletes. They didn't really care about the everyday person. They were just doing their job being a sports guy. Now you're sitting here by yourself with 3 or 4 guys in the room helping millions of people. Don't sell yourself short, man. You're doing a great job.
Oh, thanks. It's
very nice, actually.
Yeah, it's very nice. Thank you. But, You know who does the most work here? Drughead.
He feeds us the
you
answers.
You asked him about his hillbilly heroin.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. And he does all the work while he's high on Oxy, too. So. Hi, The Edge.
Hello.
Hi.
How's it going, guys?
Good, bud. What's up?
Awkward male question for Dean.
Yep.
I was talking to you about have you ever experienced... But old,
we go from standing up for women and children to, hey, does it hurt when you bust a nut? I love this. I love you, man. No.
What was the question I missed? I was
does
laughing
it hurt
too
sometimes
hard.
When you, if it's been a while,
the
yes.
The third time it does.
Yeah, and then the nards ache.
I've had it done for about maybe 3.5 years.
What, a vasectomy?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And sometimes when we go for a while and I hold it in or, you know, a little bit longer than usual, after you bust a nut, it's pain. And I don't want nobody to touch me. Like, it hurts my stomach, everything. And, like, you got kicked in the nuts.
Oh, poor guy.
Does it hurt the top portion or the
frank or the beans?
Yeah.
The beans, like, it hurts.
Oh, I didn't realize that.
Well,
oh,
two things. Okay. How much do you weigh?
Me, about 155, 160.
Oh, how tall are you?
5'6", 5'7".
Oh, how big is your wife?
She's about 5'5".
How much does she weigh?
115.
Well, okay.
Sure, buddy.
Yeah, okay. Well, there you go.
No,
so that hurts on the.
I think
had the beans hurt ever.
Yeah, me
unless
too.
You get the teas and
you
work.
Keep going.
Yeah,
no,
yeah.
But it depends on how aggressive you are, right? If you're being are you aggressive?
Sometimes.
You bring the thunder.
You know what? It depends. You know, like, but it's just concern about the pain. Like, I talked to even my urologist, and he told me maybe it's you're holding it in too long, or you're not. You know, letting go as often. I tell him, what do you mean? I'm not having enough sex? He goes, maybe.
What a great doctor.
Yeah,
that's an amazing doctor.
You know, sex way more.
No, let me.
I told my girl, I go, we're not having enough sex. That's why my nuts are hurting.
You know?
Well, it's true. Doctor said it.
Doctor's orders.
Here's some dude, sometimes when you get a vasectomy and they tell you this, is, you know, your physical being has changed down there, right? So things that were, how long you had it? 3 years?
3.5.
Do you have it every time or just sometimes?
Sometimes, not all the time. Even when I'm at work, like I'll be sitting, I operate heavy machinery, so maybe the movement or something.
No, I still get it. It's been like 2 months for me and I still get it.
Hey, this guy can never, ever take Tristan.
Nope. What is that?
He can operate heavy machinery. Always hits it. That's like all.
Or eat turkey. Well, do you have allergies? Because you can't take any of that stuff if you got allergies and you're working.
It's true.
Yeah.
He's right on the...
Want a Sunifed? No, you can't have it.
It's right on the label. Yeah.
Do not operate heavy machinery, man. Hi, The Edge.
Hey, guys. How's it going?
Good. What's up?
I'm going to Vegas this weekend. I was looking for some advice.
Oh, dude.
Spearmint Rhino.
And a lot of condoms.
Yeah, Spearmint Rhino.
He's gone?
No, he's gone. Tell him he's probably listening. Where did
you got to go to like the Wynn or one of the clubs, and you got to
Pure is a good one.
But you got to you got to be a roller. Like you got to be prepared
pretend
to drop $5,000 one night and then you have it all.
Mm-hmm. You
got to get a booth. You got to get bottle service. You got to do it up.
Yep, Todd's right. And you got to go to the Spearmint Rhino and ask for Tamara.
Oh, she's good.
Tell her Dean says hi.
Although I don't know if he's going with friends, but I know a guy who used to be in Vegas a lot.
Yeah.
And his move would be this. He would be like dancing at a club and just be in the club.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, like there's always business guys and suits and stuff. And then he would just sort of make friends with these guys and they would bring him over to their table, talk business. And then all of a sudden now he's part of the entourage and stuff.
And he gets what a sweet
move. It's like a great move. Walk out of there spending $5.
Yeah. It's a sweet, cheap move too. Yeah. I didn't realize that. That is awesome.
Yeah, so you befriend the dudes, get to their table who have all the women because they just want to go where the booze is.
Yeah.
And the money.
The wieners.
The specific women who are in that club.
Oh.
Not all women.
Okay, thank
just
you. Yeah, don't
there.
Negatively stereotype all women,
Todd.
I
just want to make that clear.
Just certain women.
Who were there.
And I'm sure men, too.
Yes.
Girls, you can do the same. You go to a club, you get a table full of bottles. And then you just have all the hot guys come over.
That doesn't happen, though.
I mean, some of the hot guys, because I don't want to include all hot guys.
It's the Dean Blundell Show. Head for the hills! 102.1, The Edge.
Hi, The Edge.
Hey, how's it going?
Good, what's up?
Hi, just listening to your station, but I was flipping through. I just heard a really poor attempt at a week.
Hi, The Edge.
Hi.
That guy wasn't a girl, and he was a dickhead. Hi, The Edge.
Hi.
Hi, who's this?
It's Nicole.
Nicole, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Still good. What's up?
I'm calling for What's Happened.
Are you really?
Yeah.
I'm calling for What's Happened. What's happened?
What happened?
Go ahead.
Okay, what happened? I was giving my husband some mouth love.
Yeah, that girl.
How old are you, by the way?
44.
Over 30.
You're over 30?
Yes.
44.
Over 40?
Over 40.
Yeah. We don't know you. We don't know who you are. We'll never find out. It's okay. You can say.
Be proud.
I'm trying to ascertain whether or not women who have been married for a long time still and their husbands stuff, still do that. That's what I'm asking.
Yes, yes.
So women over 40 still don't mind doing that?
No, no problem.
Yeah.
Hey. God bless you. Okay, keep going.
Okay, well, this particular time, he was enjoying it. And just before he was going to release, you know, his manhood, I could feel a pubic hair back my throat. And I have a hard time with hair. And as I'm trying to do the business and do that, I gagged and everything came out through the nose.
Oh, she got
the angry dragon.
One half of the angry dragon. Yeah, yeah.
Incidental angry dragoning. Hi, The Edge.
Hi, how you doing?
Good, you?
Is it ladies only?
What happened?
Yeah, but just for girls, dude.
Oh, is it? Oh,
that's okay. Don't worry about it. Have a great day. Hi, The Edge.
He's going to tell a story.
Yeah, I'm calling for what's happened.
You're not a girl either. Hi, The Edge.
Yeah, I got two comments about the show.
Okay, but you're not a girl.
I know, and I'm not asking any questions. I just wanted to give you a comment.
Yeah, let's take him.
Okay. Oh, sorry. Yeah, welcome to the Todd show. Welcome. Go ahead, dude.
If you took away the good advice and the fact that people can air out their problems, you guys still help people with the, like, laugh out loud, crash your car humor.
Oh, thanks, man. I didn't know you were going to say something nice. Keep going.
I had a feeling he was.
All right, keep going.
The other thing is that the one thing that made me angry about the show is that whip guy is complaining about his girlfriend having a foursome. Every guy dreams of that kind of memory.
What?
There was a guy who complained once about having a foursome.
Oh, yeah, that guy was a pussy. Hey, dude.
Oh, man, tell me about it. Like,
total pussy. Yeah, because he was upset because he had to have a foursome. He didn't want to have a foursome. Hi, The Edge.
Hi.
Who was this?
Natalie.
What happened?
Sound pretty.
What the f*** happened? What the f*** happened?
You sound so pretty.
Do I?
Yeah.
Are you a bit of a hoss, though?
Yeah.
I knew it.
Yep,
there you go. Dude, don't mess with me. I can see people through the phone. I'm like,
well, how much do you weigh?
Probably 210.
What am I, okay, then what am I wearing?
Extra large. Something loose? Something bigger?
Something sweaty?
What did you say? Knee pads? Is that what you said?
Turtleneck and knee pads.
I like you. What's your name?
Natalie.
Natalie, sorry, go ahead.
I'm calling for what happened, right?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, so my boyfriend is, like, not circumcised. Can I see that?
Yeah.
Yeah, you know the technical term for that is freak.
Yeah. Gross.
He's also a redhead.
And oh.
Can I say his name too? His name's Brian too.
His name's my God.
Is he adopted?
The perfect storm.
No, he's not adopted.
Okay.
Almost.
Okay, so my story is, since I get really turned off that he's like a freak, I guess that's what you call it, but Brian.
Go ahead.
Okay, so I like him to, you know, do the house love. Yeah, okay. So one day I'm sitting on him and he had gotten new pillows, and I'm allergic to like those goose feather pillows. Mm-hmm. And like
everything started to get itchy.
No, like I started sneezing, right? So
where's this going?
And he's like, is everything okay? I'm like, yeah, it's cool. And I sneezed so hard while I was sitting on him that I like almost broke his nose. Like, he started bleeding.
Yeah. You win. Congratulations.
Yeah. I don't need that. Winner on the Dean Blundell Show.
Wow.
Yay.
Is he okay?
Yeah, he's like traumatized and like.
Do you get nosebleed?
Yeah, hundo, yeah.
Dude, that's something to brag about if you're the guy.
Yeah.
Like, you know, you get in a hockey fight or something, you can show off your scars.
Dude, also, it's you can brag if you're the chick that gave him the broken nose
that's
with her.
That's a powerful punani.
Yeah.
That is some kind of wizard sleeve.
Ew.
The Dean Blundell Show.
DBS.
On the Edge.
Hit it.
To the beat, y'all.
I'm licking my lips, my fingers is sticky. Who's in the house? It's psychic Nikki.
Yeah, come on.
What's that?
Maybe your life is full of sorrow. Y'all listen up. This chick sees to
thing, y'all. It's psychic Nikki.
Oh, yeah. Do that thing. Oh, they're rubbing butts.
Boy, I just did my thing.
Oh, I got a zit on my butt.
All right.
I haven't had that forever.
Just now?
Well, I got it from Nikki.
You did not.
To work.
That's weird.
That is weird.
I think it's from all the heat. Is it from all the heat?
Yeah, it is. Probably. It's from heat.
Yeah.
Everybody's being itchy. Everything is.
I got acne.
You got to take a Claritin. That's
acne on your ass. Acne.
Get it? Acne.
Right.
How are you?
I'm great, Dean.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What's up?
What's up? Well, what's
good.
Up?
You look good, girl.
Thank you. I lost 12 pounds. That's
did
why.
You really?
Yeah.
Oh, get
and I,
out
I'm
of
continuing
here.
To lose.
No,
so.
You're not.
Yeah.
Listen to me.
Dean.
I love you very much. I really do. But every couple of months, you come in here losing 12 pounds. And if I'm to do my math over the past several years, you should weigh negative 40.
Okay,
you owe
but
your
I
body
did,
weight.
Dean, honestly, I lost 12 pounds.
Stay up your shirt. Okay.
Yeah, let's well, see what you
yeah,
get.
Yeah, let's see oh, your...
See how things are doing.
Yeah.
She showed your hip.
Yeah.
My broken hip? No, no.
Yeah. How are you?
I'm fine.
Good. Let's bang some predictions real quick if we can.
Okay, now I did... And I feel terrible about the person that died, but I did predict the stage prediction.
Dude, oh yeah, my God, I almost said dead on. I didn't mean to do that.
Okay, yeah, no, and on. I really feel bad for all the people
that got
hurt.
Yeah, it was a killer prediction.
Yeah, I feel bad.
It was very good.
It. Yeah.
It was a very, no, it was an unbelievable prediction because it happened in a matter of days. Not right. even. One day. Was it one day?
It was like the next day.
It was the next day. Mm-hmm. And then it happened.
Boom.
You must when they're close, they're actually going to happen. Do they become very visual?
Very visual.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's what I would think.
I'm very visual. And, you know, I feel bad that I can't, you know, tell the people ahead of time all the time. So I feel bad, you know.
Well, or not.
Yeah. And I also predicted Johnny Depp would get separated.
Yeah. And he did.
Yeah, he did.
And I always loved his wife. Though.
Yeah.
She's hot.
Yeah. Now you really can if you like.
Oh, yeah, I'll try.
Yeah. He's pretty...
You know,
yeah.
Johnny Depp or me.
You're a good-looking dude.
Right, thanks, man.
What is it about when celebrities, really hot female celebrities, break up with their boyfriends that the regular dude, the regular guy out there, seems to think he's got a chance? It's
exactly.
like, great news. Irina Shayk broke up with Ronaldo? That's great. I got to take my shot.
Now, Jupiter is going to turn direct June 27th. What that means is there'll be a lot of weddings in Hollywood. A lot of people giving good news, like babies, they may be pregnant.
Why only in Hollywood?
Well, not only in Hollywood, all over the world.
Well, you said Hollywood.
Well, a lot of the Hollywood types, yeah. And now I'm getting crows attacking people. Now, I said this before, because things are getting a little bit juicy out there before 2012. Now...
Juicy.
Now,
words I never want to hear come out of Nikki's mouth ever again.
I know. She was saying it. I was getting grossed out. Juicy out there.
Yeah. Now, crows, they can recognize faces, okay? So if they recognize your face, they can warn the other crows to attack. That's true.
Damn.
They have a brain. Yeah, but I see them attacking people.
Okay.
And I almost saw them attacking a woman at a bus stop the other day.
Oh, you almost saw them?
Yeah, well, like...
Like you were going
they were
too fast were thinking about it,
no,
and then they decided not to.
No, I was in a cab, and
happening?
I saw it, and even the cab driver said, wow...
No, but what do you mean? What did they almost like? You,
oh my
because
God!
Because I didn't see all of it because I was
you mean
moving. Like
you saw crows that were they were poised to attack.
They were all around
some
the
homeless
and they
person
drove by
and a bus stop. And you drove by, so you don't know if they
and
attacked
the cabbie
or not.
Was like, the cabbie was like, oh my God, the crows are going to attack him.
That's exactly what he said.
Doesn't it look very funny, Nikki, that the crows might attack that homeless lady?
Yeah, because...
I will drive on.
Yeah, because that man said there's a lot of crows where he lives in
what'd
his homeland.
Say?
He said crows have eyes that are very big.
No, he didn't.
Say?
No,
what'd
he didn't.
Say?
Crows have eyes that are very big.
But he also said there's vultures where he lives, too.
No, he
too.
Didn't.
Yes, he did.
There are vultures where I live
vultures.
As well.
They're scary. Vultures.
Can we keep going here?
Yes, yes. Now,
repeating the word
now
vultures.
A farmer's going to get killed by a cow. And listen, to all the cow lovers out there, I love cows, okay?
Okay.
I love them.
No one cares.
People do
just
care.
Keep going. No, they don't. They don't care
cows?
That you love cows.
Cows kill farmers
okay, now,
all the time.
Now, he's going to pull too hard
steak.
On the rudder or whatever it is. Was it the rudder?
The Dutch rudder?
Yeah, you know, yep. He's going to pull too hard. The cow's going to...
Utter, not rudder.
Yeah, utter.
It's not a boat.
Steer that cow.
Yeah, right.
They're going
to... Sorry about
the cow.
Steer the cow right into the dock. Steer
about the udder. That's what it is. Yeah. So then it's going to be a stall with two other cows, and they're also going to give a kick in. So the poor farmer's going to be, you know, he's not going to be there.
My, how the tables have turned.
Right.
I figured it out.
Oh, some guy figured out?
Yeah.
Really?
Whatever. Email me. Some guy figured out the joke.
Really?
Yeah, the Luca Magnotta joke.
Yeah.
Oh.
This is the punchline for it. I can't tell you the joke because it's just way offside. I can tell you the punchline, though. My, how the tables have turned.
Hey, how about that head, though?
Oh, my God.
Oh, yeah.
Did you see that?
I did not see that.
Metro newspaper. I don't know who's in charge over there.
I think it's
like
the Star or the Sun.
Some,
it's one of the
some
affiliates.
Dorks. They it's not? So anyway, they do the Magnota back in Canada. And then right next to it, pictures of people dancing. It said, everybody cuts foot loose.
Really? Oh, my God. That's rude.
Yeah, I'm going to retweet it. Someone tweeted it to me. Can I retweet that?
That's awful. Though.
Yeah.
It's awful.
Magnota back in Canada. Everybody cut foot loose.
Oh, my God. I guess it's to sell papers, but it's kind of gross.
No, I don't think they knew.
No,
I think it was like because Footloose
wrong.
Is in town.
Oh, and they just,
but it's the way it was like all like, yeah.
The way that it just happened.
It was just.
Wow. That's scary.
Yeah.
That's scary. Now, they're going to find. Now, this is. I know you don't like these things, Dean, but they're going to find a blue beaver. Now.
It's probably some punk rock chick.
Yeah. I thought it was bluewaffle.com, isn't it?
It's probably Katy Perry.
It's like an albino or albino or whatever it is.
Oh,
albino.
Yeah, like it's a very rare beaver and it's all going to be blue.
I thought it was just sad.
Did you see the lobster they found?
No.
They found a complete blue lobster, one of like.
I said that too. Yeah.
Oh, you said that too?
I said that too about a year ago.
Blue beaver, there's like a Princess Di joke in there somewhere.
Oh, really? Oh, boy.
I don't know. Anyway.
2 days later.
Go ahead.
Anyway. Now, that's scary.
If you find it, people
are going to be. There's going to be flying people in the future. Now, we will be able to fly.
We can like, now.
I'm sorry?
No, she's talking personally.
Oh, like
no,
with a
personal
like
flight
wings.
Device.
Like they're going to have a device, and people will be flying around with flying cars as well.
Right.
So you take your choice.
Yeah, keep going.
Yeah, okay.
I'm
motoring through it right now. Okay, there's going to be a rabid epidemic around Southern Ontario. Squirrels, rabbits, dogs, everybody.
Okay.
Yeah, rabbit.
Rabies.
A rabies thing. Now, I see a plane crashing into a lighthouse. That's not good. Near water.
It's pretty good aim.
It's like I know. It's like the one thing.
And I see glass falling off of a building again, but this time it's going to kill two people. That's not
good. Yeah, you know what? I've been so scared of that.
Yeah,
all
that's
this stuff.
Scary.
There's two things I won't do. One of them is go downtown. I honest to God, I won't because everybody... And then yesterday they make this announcement. They're like, yeah, we're going to change how they're doing it.
New
to put glass in the new buildings. And we just hope that people change the glass in the old ones.
Yeah.
We hope they do. You know, we're just hoping
it's
they
so
do.
It's so scary, though. You think about how many times it's been happening. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, it's very scary, and I hope it doesn't happen, but I see it happening. I saw a vision of it. Now, I also see in Louisiana a giant snail eating people. Just a minute. I told you this is like giant sea monsters.
All right.
Yeah.
Oh, they also found a flying saucer.
Yeah, they
underneath
did.
You know
the
what?
Baltic Sea.
I read that. Yeah. And they don't know what it is, but it's interesting.
Yeah. Mm. You see, this is.
Then again, those Chinese villagers didn't know what a dildo was. So
this is true. Okay. Oh, the guy thought it was a big mushroom.
Yeah.
He's like, and it was a dildo with the front and the back on it.
Yeah. Oh, really?
So you could stick your.
Well, I don't think this is a dildo. Not from what I saw.
Oh, okay.
Oh, it was a guy dildo.
It's a gildo.
I think it was a spaceship from a long time ago.
Yeah, we know. Keep
yeah.
Going.
Okay. Okay. And I see New York underwater, New York City.
Yeah?
Yeah, just underwater.
Like a couple of feet or all the way?
I think quite a bit of water. Like not just a couple of feet.
That'd be bad.
Yeah, like I see Central Park.
I heard
Park.
There's a lot of people there.
Yeah, I see Central Park. I see Fifth Avenue, Broadway, like near the Mayor Bloomberg's
office.
Like I see it around there. It's kind of scary. Soho District.
Okay.
Yeah. New York. Good for you.
New York.
Yeah, all the boroughs.
Yeah. Now in the all the boroughs, right. Now in the future, people
Manhattan,
aren't gonna have money.
Queens.
Ithaca.
They're not gonna carry money. It's gonna be a money card.
Well, we all know that.
No, not just like a credit card, but just a money card. That's it. That's what you're gonna have.
Dude, I think I'm psychic. I had thought about something like that.
You did?
Yeah.
But you're going to have a limit on it. But it's not going to be like an ordinary...
Yeah, it's a bank card, loser.
No, it is not.
The limit is what you have in your account.
It's not a bank card, Dean. This is something different. You're not going to carry cash anymore.
Why are you getting mad at me?
Oh, I'm not. I'm not. I am definitely not. A lady's going to pickle her husband.
Sure, the husband's not going to pickle the lady. Starts with a cucumber, leave it in there a while. Boom, it's a pickle.
No,
that
he's
the greatest prediction of all time.
Hey, dude, you know that UFO at the bottom of the Baltic Sea?
Yeah.
It looks exactly like the Millennium Falcon. I'm not kidding.
Really?
Dude, it's crazy.
It's a model.
Okay.
Have you seen it? It's got like boxes and squares and marks. It's nuts. Look at it. Millennium Falcon, undersea. Millennium Falcon. Look at it. Yeah, that's crazy.
Wow.
That's
See, I said
Isn't
there's...
Isn't that nuts?
I also see a pink, actually, spaceship. Pink.
Pink spaceship?
Yeah.
Back to the pickled husband.
Yeah, back to the pickle. Now, this woman, she's going to have an abusive husband, and she's going to be hitting her, and he likes pickles. He's always making pickles, so she's going to pickle him.
Oh, she gets him back. It's not like
it's a big jar.
Yeah, in a big jar, like she's going to get back at him.
Oh, you'd really need a big fork to crack her open at the start.
How do you mean?
You know what I hate about pickles? I was trying to invent something where you could, sorry if this sounds off, but I was trying to invent something that you don't have to use, like you get an extra long skinny fork.
Yeah.
Or change how wide the mouths of the jars are so you can actually get your hands in there so you get a goddamn pickle.
Dude, there's some hockey player on the Ottawa Senators, I think he's a rookie, who invented like this, he's got a patent on the peanut butter jar.
Yeah.
Because you know it's like at the end, it's tough to get in the knife way deep in the, so you screw off the plastic, so it's like, and then you can put the lid back on and you get half the peanut butter jar.
Yeah.
Well,
something like
cool.
that. Yeah, yeah.
That's cool.
Super cool.
But I, you know, I'm not telling people to pickle their husbands.
Just oh, I wonder if you, I thought you were.
You think about tangy or garlic?
Kosher deal? Anyway.
The Dean Blundell Show. Mornings.
It's so crazy.
On the Edge.
Nikki's here. Good morning.
Good morning, Dean.
How are you?
I am great. Because
what
it's
you
Friday
doing?
And I'm here with you
Friday.
Guys.
Freddy.
Now, I see a plane crashing Air France at Charles de Gaulle Airport in France.
Dude, that's big. That's a big.
Yeah.
That's huge.
I see a false alarm all over the world, like a siren going off. It's a false alarm of a nuclear attack, but it's just false.
On the Simpsons.
On the Simpsons?
It's off of the nuclear plant.
Let's go.
Now, a man will die from too many hot peppers, eating too many hot peppers in South America.
Oh, I was going to say, it might be my dad. He eats a lot of hot peppers.
Oh, he does?
Yeah, he loves the hot peppers, Jimmy.
Oh.
Loves them.
Oh, well, we don't want that.
Nope.
There's going to be a fungus around birch trees. I see a submarine sinking, a U.S. submarine sinking. Mm. Could be attacked. And I see more monster songs coming up. You know, like the Purple People Eater, Monster Mash, and more weird rock bands, like, you know, like Kiss, like Gene Simmons. They're going to have more bands like that with makeup and everything. So how do you feel about that, Dean?
Really good.
Good, good.
Yeah.
Good. You like that, do you?
Jesus, I feel like I'm in bed with her.
Really?
Yeah, how do you feel about that, Dean? You like that, do you?
It's
like
juicy. That?
It's juicy.
That I gotta say yes.
All right.
All right.
Hi, The Edge. Hello.
Hello.
Hey, man, you got a question for Nikki?
I do.
Sure, go ahead. Yeah, go ahead.
My girlfriend and her son recently moved into my house, and I've been hearing, like, noises. Like, I've lived there for, like, 2 years.
Okay.
And... at 10:20, like three times in 1 week, her son woke up. Like he gets all restless, like from his sleep, and he was like crying and crying. So every night, like around that time, he gets restless around like 10:20.
Really? And this is her son, you said?
Yes. Yeah, he's 3 years old.
Okay, and this happened before they moved into your house?
I've heard noises before they moved in.
You did?
But ever since they moved in, like this last month, he's been waking up at 10:20, 10:19,
Okay, now children are more susceptible to ghosts.
Have you checked to see if maybe there's an alarm in that room that's set for 10:19, 10:20?
No alarm.
Okay.
No, there's definitely something there, but because the child's there, because children, they're more susceptible to that. So the ghosts come out more when that happens. And you could have heard those weird sounds, and the ghosts might not have come up when you were there. So it's something to do with a child.
What does it mean, though, Nikki, when it falls on a certain time?
Because that person could have died at that time.
Yeah.
The ghost could have died at that time or was born at that time, either way.
You know what's funny?
Yeah.
Because of how accurate she's been lately,
I believe
I take her like 40% more seriously.
Yeah, I'm with you. I'm totally with you.
Thanks, Steve. Thanks. No, but it's true.
Yeah, so, I believe it.
Yeah, so the ghost could have, you know, been born or died in a tragic way at that particular point in time.
Whew. Ghosts.
Okay.
Yeah. And so is he wants to know if it's going to stop, I bet, huh?
It's not going to stop. You have to kind of ignore the ghost for the time being. And I think you're a little bit scared.
I'm nervous for my girlfriend's son.
Yeah, but the ghost won't hurt her son. It won't. You'll be fine.
Okay. Like,
but I do see you moving away from there eventually. I don't see you living there.
Okay.
Okay, so I see you moving within a year.
Okay, should I keep checking on her son at that time, like open the bedroom door?
Well, you can, and as I told people before, take a camera, video camera, and just take pictures. Okay, because it'll show up in the pictures. It'll show up as a light or something like that.
Okay.
Okay, but don't be frightened.
Yeah. And, you know, ask before you go in his room at night.
But I'm getting a fire around that ghost, too.
Are you?
Yeah, like a
fire.
Can
a ghost catch on fire?
No, it could have been how the person died or something.
I don't know. Hi, The Edge.
Hey, Dean. Michael here. I was hoping to talk to Nikki and ask about my sister, who recently had a brain aneurysm, trying to find out what she sees for the future. For
tough
her.
One, dude. She really has a hard time with medical predictions, and only not because she doesn't see them, but because she really doesn't like giving people any hope or false hope and stuff, and
no,
she doesn't want to give you bad news either. But do you want to know if she's going to be with us in the year 2015?
That would be lovely.
She doesn't know. She can't. Honest. And
because it's not her reading. It's yours.
Yeah. So you get to call in, and if she phoned, which would be hard to do with the whole.
Yeah.
You know, then you could do that, right?
Yeah. I don't like to give them. I'm not a doctor.
Yeah.
So
and
I
apologize
like
for hanging up on it, but we just got to hustle. Hi, The Edge.
Hey, what's going on, guys? It's just, Monica.
Hey, Monica. What's
up?
Going on with you?
What's up, girl?
Not much, guys. I'm just going to pull over here so I can talk to Nikki. So, my question for Nikki, I've been doing fertility with my husband for about the last year. It's my birthday tomorrow, and a year ago yesterday I was at the fertility doctor. Tomorrow, going to fertility.
You're going to have twins.
Well, really?
Yeah, came right up.
Okay, that's, will it happen? Because, like, we've been married for 8 years, and, I mean, there's nothing wrong with him.
No.
I had surgery a year ago, and...
You know, sometimes it takes longer with certain people. I don't know why.
How old are you?
I'm going to be 34 tomorrow.
And how long have you been trying to have kids?
Well, for a good 3-4 years now.
Like, have you? Can I ask you a question?
Of course, Dean.
Have you guys tried the wheelbarrow? Do you know what that is?
Oh, absolutely. We know what that is.
You sound happy about it.
Because I've heard that if you do the wheelbarrow where the woman pretends to do a push-up, the guy gets behind, grabs the legs, pull you right in. What happens is that the gravity there
got nowhere else to go.
Gets all the stuff right up into the guts, right? Gets up in your guts.
Well, guess what we're going to be doing on day 13?
Yay! That's good.
Twins, day 13. Congratulations.
That'll be so good.
Hi, The Edge.
Hey, what's going on?
I hope she names one of them after us.
Yeah, Dean and Todd.
Oh, God.
What if they're girls?
I think they're boys. No, you know what? I kind of picked up boys.
Hi, The Edge. Sorry, dude. Go ahead.
Hey, how's it going, guys?
Good, brother. How you doing?
Not bad. Okay, so I got a serious question for Nate.
Yeah.
Whoa. Close your window.
What?
Close your window.
Too much wind, dude.
Yeah, too much wind. Yeah, a lot of wind comes through here. All right.
Yeah, that's enough of that. Hi, The Edge. Hello.
Hi, is this The Edge?
Yep.
This is Nikki.
Yeah, what's your question?
Yeah, what does she see for my future modeling and acting career?
Modeling and acting?
Taurus. I'm a Taurus, yeah.
Oh, very good. Tauruses are very good.
So he's going to model and act?
Yeah, I see him modeling and acting.
By the edge.
Maybe
porn.
A porno film. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. Or a B-movie.
Wished I wouldn't have hung up on him.
All right.
By the edge, sorry.
Hello.
Hey, man.
Hey, I'm Red speaking.
Wake up.
Yeah, go ahead.
Oh, thank you. I was just wondering, my wife, she's not very good, you know, like...
She's not good?
She's not good at the...
Can you please take the keys out of your car?
Oh, sorry. So she's not very good. Like, she arranged marriage, right?
Oh, it's an arranged marriage and you don't like her?
I didn't see her in the beginning, but now... No, in the wedding, she looked good, but now she's very hairy, like... Like, you know, bro, I don't like it, man. Like, I want to know if my future is good if I get a new wife.
Okay, just a minute. You said she's heavier?
Hello?
What did you say?
I caught a unibrow. I caught a unibrow in there. I think I caught a unibrow.
Just a minute.
I'll recap.
I can't catch my breath.
Here.
Recap.
This guy called. What's your name?
My name is Raj.
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 Raj called to tell you he's in an arranged marriage. At the wedding, she looked okay. Now she's let herself go. Lots of hairy eyebrows. And yes, she.
It's very bad, man. I don't like it, you know?
You don't like it?
I don't blame you. It's one of my least favorite things on women is hair.
Yeah, Dean hates it.
Unfortunately, I see you going to strip joint soon.
I went last week.
But... Oh, good.
Hey, dude, do you like talking to her? Do you like hanging out with her or no?
I don't know, man. All she does is cook, and I don't know. She tried to have the sexy time, but I don't like it, man. She's heavy everywhere.
Maybe she'll get
dude,
cancer.
Is it against your...
No.
Dude.
Was that nice. Outside?
For chemo, you mean?
Yeah, maybe she'll
get cancer.
Yeah, I meant to get chemo.
No, of course not.
She's a woman that likes to cook and clean.
Hang on, I got it. Just give me a second.
It's okay if she has hair, you know, maybe a little on the arm or anything, but this is on the face, man. I don't blame you.
It's gross. I've been saying it for years. So can I ask you something?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so when you come home and you see her, do you want to have sex with her, or is it too gross for you?
No, that is the thing. I don't want to do it.
Yeah, can you? What happens in your religion if, like, you are you allowed to shave her?
The shaving is no problem. She's not maintaining. That's the problem.
Oh,
she's not maintaining.
Dude, maybe you can get like
tell her.
No, maybe you get like a spa gift certificates and like every 2 weeks or something. Is that like something like that? Would that work?
Or start calling her Chewy.
Chewy.
No,
you gotta eat cherries, both of you.
Why?
Because that's what I'm getting, Dean.
Cherries?
Yeah.
Here, this is what I think you need to do. I think you need to go have that hoss waxed.
But she's not growing. That's the problem. I want to know if my future I get a new wife, man.
Yeah. He wants a new wife.
Yeah, you can get a new wife. Yeah, the arranged marriages are the best ones, right? Because you can go, I didn't like this one. I want a new one. It's like when you go home with a pair of sneakers and 2 days later you go, not comfortable.
Yeah, you just rearrange.
No, I do see you in another marriage for sure.
Okay. That is all I need.
Wait,
I like this guy.
That's the initial R.
This guy's awesome.
Yes, thank you.
Okay. Yeah, I feel bad for him, you know?
So do I. Yeah. I feel bad for any man whose girlfriend / wife has copious amounts of hair.
The unibrow.
Oh, dude. And do you remember that one chick you dated with sideburns?
Yeah.
She was so gross. And then we talked about her on the air for so long, apparently, without saying her name.
Apparently
Sheila went and got waxed. And
no, she got laser surgery.
Spent thousands of dollars on laser surgery.
Oh, yeah, this dude can get laser surgery for his woman.
Yeah, go get laser surgery for her.
It's not only the unibrow, man. It's the mustache, man.
Oh, bad news.
Yeah, but she can get that
What's it
waxed.
Like down there? What's
she
it like
can get
down
it
there?
Waxed.
What's it like down there?
It's very terrible.
When's the last time you saw it?
I think, like, last week, man. I don't go home that much now.
You don't?
No, dude, he's living with Sasquatch.
Oh, yeah, I'd be afraid, too.
Have you talked to her about going to a spa to get it waxed?
She doesn't want to do it, man. That's...
Did you ask her why?
I asked her, you know, could you maintain, please? Like, I don't like it, but...
don't know. She doesn't. She just shrugs it off. Shrugs.
What about if you did it?
What do you say?
What about if you did it?
I'm clean, man. I am.
No, not, I know you're clean, but what if you shaved it or something? I don't know.
Dude, here this.
I see you marrying somebody else within.
Yeah.
Two
well, then
years.
We don't need yeah. him to tell him to shave it.
Right.
They dude, like duster. Shaving parties.
Yeah.
That's good enough. That's
okay, buddy. Yeah. Have a great day.
That's good enough.
And it's S the first name and R the last initial is her name, the new one.
Really?
Yeah.
That's great.
S and R.
Sarah Rogers.
I highly doubt that guy's going to marry a chick named Sarah Rogers.
The Dean Blundell Show, 102.1 The Edge.